Hello everyone, welcome back to the Science Hub. Michelle Tetu,
Michelle Gabani,
and Tiffany McKenna.
Today we'll be talking about aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration is the respiration that takes place in the presence of oxygen, so it is therefore the process by which food substances are broken down, such as glucose, in the presence of oxygen. And the first stage is glucose glycolysis, that is the breaking down of glucose. It involves splitting of glucose in pyruvic acid. One molecule of glucose is split into two molecules of pyruvic acid. The aerobic takes place in the matrix and does not require the presence of oxygen. In aerobic respiration, the pyruvic acid formed during glycolysis enters the mitochondria and undergoes further breakdown to produce more energy. My friend Tetu will take us to the equation for the process of aerobic respiration.
This equation, it takes place in both animals and plants.
Glucose plus oxygen.
It's equal to carbon 4 oxide. Plus energy, which is also known as ATP. The ATP, it means adenosine triphosphate. So after this equation, we're going to explain the purpose of the equation. 60% of the energy was released, and some of it is lost, and the other one can be used to warm the body. Again, we're told that some of the energy that was released was immediately used by the cells, and the other one was converted to form energy, which is also known as ATP. Energy, that is ATP, it is a combination of a complex organic molecule. So it will form ATP. ATP is written in form of three letters, that is ATP. That's why we call it adenosine triphosphate, because it has the three P's. But if we eliminate this one P, it will be known as adenosine diphosphate. So the adenosine triphosphate is converted to form energy, which is known as adenosine triphosphate. Thank you. So I'll give it up to my colleague Tiffany to explain on the phases of respiration.
We have two major phases of respiration. That is the first phase and the second phase. The first phase, we talked about it earlier on anaerobic respiration. So we go to the second phase, respiration, which takes place in the matrix of the mitochondria. In the second phase, the pyruvic acid is formed in the first phase, is further oxidized when we come to the second phase. Then we go on to the conditions for the second phase. The cells that are in the second phase must be provided with food. Oxygen must be taken with glucose to be able to... Then after that, glucose is broken down to glycolysis. Then there must be an enzyme to catalyze the reaction. Then we also have favorable of temperature to be maintained. Then I'll pass it on to Michelle to explain the practical activity.
The first step is place some food sample in a dry test tube and insert on a holder rubber stopper into the mouth of the test tube.
This is the starch. We'll use a spatula to put it into the boiling tube.
Then hold the test tube containing the food sample horizontally, pour a little calcium hydroxide solution into another test tube and support it.
This calcium hydroxide.
Then, using a delivery tube, connect the two test tubes.
This delivery tube.
Then heat the test tube containing the food sample.
We'll use a spirit lamp to heat.
Then observe and record what happens to the food sample. I'll now leave it to Tetu to explain the observations.
As you can all see, the food substance, which was starch, it's being heated. So the water, as we know that food, it contains some water. This water that was in the food substance will come and settle here at the delivery tube, going through the delivery tube, and it will enter in the calcium hydroxide solution. When the water, when you combine water plus anhydrous copper sulfate, it will form hydrated copper sulfate. So this is our water that we got it from the starch. When it went through the delivery tube and entered the copper 2 sulfate solution, it will make this copper 2 sulfate solution, which was hydrated to become, which was anhydrous, to become hydrated due to the water that was added into it. And the copper 2 sulfate was white in color before this water was added into it. When we add the water from the starch to the copper 2 sulfate solution, it will turn to blue. In other cases, if we were given cobalt 2 chloride, which is blue in color, if we add water from the starch to the cobalt 2 chloride, which was blue, it will turn it into pink and it will be anhydrous cobalt 2 chloride. Now, I leave it on to Tiffany.
We have come to the end of our discussion today on Science Hub. I have been Tiffany McKenna.
Michelle Tito.
Michelle Gathoni.
Keep it Elimu TV, where we watch and learn.